Separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Santa's. He'll never forget us. God sends us his love on the wings of a dove.
How can we know the way? Jesus said to them, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated. For those of you who may not know me, I'm Timothy Hyder. I'm a transitional deacon. I'll be ordained a priest here in a couple weeks, and I'm a cousin of Peggy's. My mom is Peggy's first cousin, and so that's how I got to know Peggy. And I'll go into that a little bit more about who Peggy was to me and to all of us here. But first, I want to focus on the scripture, on what Christ has given us today through his word, through the Gospel of John. He says, do not let your hearts be troubled. We may, for different reasons, our hearts may be troubled today, whether it's the sudden loss of Peggy, the loss of her friendship, her laughter, her kindness, all the good things that Peggy was to so many of us. We may be troubled because we may have had unfinished business with Peggy. We may have, been on her about her health or on different things or wished she had done things differently. But the Lord tells us, do not let your hearts be troubled. And he tells us that nothing will separate us from him, through the first reading from Paul. Nothing will separate us from the love of Christ. Whether that be ourselves, our disagreements with one another, or sadness or pain, nothing will separate us from God. And Peggy knew that as good as anyone, that nothing could separate her from God. And this story that I'm about to share shows that very strongly, that Peggy knew who God was to her, and she shared that through her way of being with others, through her kindness, through her love, through her compassion, through her stories. And that with that, I'll go into a story about Peggy. About 2 years ago, I was in Odessa at Holy Redeemer, and I did my internship there. And the receptionist came to me and said that a cousin had called and wanted me to go visit her. I didn't know all the details just right away, but I came to find out that it was Peggy. And so I came to Midland, and Peggy had been really sick. This was one of the toughest points in Peggy's life. And she had had a really, really rough week there in the hospital. And I came to realize that she called me for three reasons. She called me, number one, because not because I was so great, but because it wasn't me that she wanted. It was God that she wanted. It was, she wanted something that was going to help point her to God. And she asked the receptionist to have me bring the daily readings, the daily mass readings, and a rosary. And so when I went and saw Peggy, we went through the readings for the day, and we prayed a decade of the rosary. And that brought Peggy so much peace, because that's what she was seeking, was God. She knew at that moment that God was present with her, and that she was going to be okay either way, whether that was her last week or whether she had more time. Well, she ended up having 2 more years, thanks to God. And through those couple of years, she continued to reach out to me. About every other month, I would get a text from Peggy asking me how I was doing and just letting me know that she was praying for me. And so I realized the other thing was, first she was seeking God, and the other thing was the church. Peggy, being Catholic was very important to Peggy. And she wanted to reach out to the church and be a part of the church. And she, that was the other reason why I'm going. She called me specifically. And she told me stories about Balmoray and the family. And part of that was the faith that her parents passed on to her. And that was very, very important to her. And particularly the rosary. Caught me off guard, but she had a devotion to Mary, and that was something that was very important to her, being able to go to Christ through Mary, and being able to have that relationship with Christ and with his mother. And so she shared those two things with me, but also the other reason that she had called me specifically was because I was family. And family was very important to Peggy. Like I said, the stories that she told of her parents and grandparents and the cousins, it made me realize how blessed that group of cousins were to grow up together, because everybody grew up there, for the most part, in Balmoray. And Peggy still had a connection to that, and that was very important to her. She was proud to be a Moor, and she was proud to be from Balmoray. And so those three things, her reaching out to God and to the church, with the church, she was very proud that this was her parish, St. Stephen's. And Monsignor Bridges, she loved Monsignor Bridges. And so I'm very thankful that we're here. Because that was important to her. And so with that, like Monsignor was saying, her parents brought her to the church for baptism. And so we bring her back to the church, praying for her and asking God's mercy upon her that she may be with him for eternity. And so in that, we know that we should not be troubled, but rather to trust in the Lord and to put Peggy in his hands and to pray for her and to pray for one another and to be there for one another. And with that, may we know that nothing can separate us from Christ and nothing can separate us from the good things that we received from Peggy in this life, that her smile and her laughter, she had a heck of a laugh. She had a good Moor laugh, and that will always be with us. And we can hold on to that, and we can hold on to Christ in the midst of this time and moving forward.
Where's sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of the glory of his name,
for I will be the wrong of the church. Look favorably on our offering, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Peggy, may be taken up into the glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. In him who rose from the dead, our hope of resurrection dawns. The sadness of death gives way to the bright promise of immortality. Lord, for your faith.
Save your God to me. Yeah.
I'm just going to sit with you now.
Right, shine.